In this video, you'll see how you can build a Java event-driven serverless application with Amazon CodeWhisperer. With this machine learning-powered service, you can build applications faster by leveraging code recommendations and implementing API calls across popular AWS services. This is the application that we're going to build with the help of Amazon CodeWhisperer. Users will have two different URLs they can interact with to download and recognize objects and images. To achieve this implementation, we'll work with four different Lambda functions. We'll begin by implementing a Lambda function that downloads an image using a provided URL and then uploads the image to Amazon S3. For demonstration purposes, we've already prepared an application with the AWS Cloud Development Kit, or AWS CDK. We'll be using Java to build our application, and IntelliJ IDEA by JetBrains as our IDE. Starting with our first Lambda function, let's type a comment that says, "Method to download an image from the web," and press Enter. CodeWhisperer guesses our intent and suggests a function name. We'll accept the suggestion we want by using our tab key. Next, let's press Enter to see CodeWhisperer's suggestions for the body of the function. Once again, we'll press Tab to accept the suggestion. Now we need to upload the image to Amazon S3. To do this, we'll enter a comment. We'll use our right arrow key to continue through the suggestions until we find the one we want to use. We'll press Tab to select this one. Let's change this to a void method, since we don't need it to return anything. Again, we'll cycle through the suggestions and select the one we want. Next, we'll begin to invoke the function we set up. This format is based on our ImageData class. Let's take a quick look at it. Let's return to our function. Now we'll upload the image. Now we'll implement our second Lambda function. This function will read an item from the Amazon Simple Queue Service, or SQS queue, use Amazon Recognition to recognize all the labels from the image, store the results in Amazon DynamoDB, and then publish the results to Amazon Simple Notification Service, or SNS. Let's start by entering method to receive a message from SQS. We'll use the second suggestion from CodeWhisperer. Now let's cycle through the suggestions for the body of the method. We'll use this last suggestion. Now let's enter method to detect labels from image with recognition. We'll accept the suggested name, which requires a bucket and key. We'll also accept the suggested implementation, which will return all the labels that are in the image. Let's make some edits to this code. Next, let's enter method to save an item on DynamoDB. We'll accept the suggested name and choose our preferred implementation. In this case, CodeWhisperer took into consideration our prior code that recognizes images from recognition when creating a format and structure for the items that will be saved. Once again, we don't need this method to return anything. Next, let's get a CodeWhisperer suggestion by entering the comment method to publish item to SNS. We'll accept the suggestion and choose our preferred implementation. Let's edit this code. Finally, let's add a method to delete the message from SQS so we don't process it twice. There's only one method suggestion for this. Let's use it. Let's review the methods that we just implemented. Now we'll start using them. The second Lambda function is now complete. Now we'll implement a third Lambda function. This function will read the object from the Amazon SQS queue that was published by the previous Lambda function. It will then convert the message from JSON to XML and send the message to an external email server. Let's start by entering method to receive and delete a message from SQS queue URL. We'll accept CodeWhisperer's suggestions. Now we'll use CodeWhisperer to find a method to convert JSON to XML. Next, we need to send the XML message to our email server using HTTP POST. Now let's call the method and pass it the appropriate parameters. Now we'll implement our fourth Lambda function. This function reads all the items from the DynamoDB table and returns them as JSON objects. We'll enter "return all items from a DynamoDB table" to get suggestions from CodeWhisperer. Let's choose the name myTableName. We can return the items by simply calling the method and passing the table as a parameter. Based on our comments written in plain natural language, CodeWhisperer generated code that matches our patterns and style, without requiring us to spend time researching methods. Now let's test this application with this image of a pug to see what it recognizes. We'll invoke the endpoint that we just deployed and then pass the URL for the image. The image uploaded successfully. Now we'll invoke the second API gateway endpoint to see the results. The application labeled our pug image tiger, wildlife, animal, mammal, canine, pet, dog, and so on, proving that our application with the code generated by CodeWhisperer is up and running. You've just seen how to build a Java event-driven serverless app with Amazon CodeWhisperer. You can learn more about this topic and sign up for the CodeWhisperer preview in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.